With U.S.-China tensions escalating, the race for sixth-generation fighter capabilities has intensified. The U.S. Air Force's Next Generation Air Dominance, NGAD program, is set to secure air superiority with advanced manned and unmanned components. Meanwhile, China's PLAAF unveiled its sixth gene fighter vision, the White Emperor, at Zhuhai Air Show. Designed under Project Nantianmen, this aircraft reportedly can break through the Earth's atmosphere, potentially operating in space. Featuring stealth-focused aerodynamic lines and internal missile bases, the White Emperor emphasizes speed and survivability. While NGAD appears closer to deployment, both powers aim to establish dominance in the air and space domains. But, at the moment, this new fighter is just a mock-up, meaning we do not have a clear sense of what the final fighter will actually look like. So, China displays this science fiction-looking mock-up and ogles over it, convincing Westerners that this system is just around the corner. In reality, they're not building it. But the Americans are foolish enough to redouble their investment in the onerous and impractical NGAD program. It breaks the back of the U.S. Air Force's finances and helps to further bankrupt the country. Pentagon leaders must not fall for it. There is no room in the budget for the sixth-generation warplane. Trying to make room for it will lead to an unmitigated disaster. It will weaken the United States military at a time when it is already weak. Again, this plays into China's hands. A far better investment would be to continue purchasing the F-35 Lightning II, building our own stealth unmanned aerial vehicles to augment existing U.S. warplanes, and, if necessary, reconstituting the shuttered F-22A Raptor production line. The aircraft, referred to in the exhibition as the White Emperor B variant, is designed to fulfill dual mission roles and is an evolution of previous stealth aircraft concepts presented by China. The showcased model indicates that AVIC has made significant modifications to the airframe, particularly focusing on the aft section and wing configurations. In addition to an advanced avionics suite, the fighter's design emphasizes pilot-machine interaction and streamlined maintenance, optimizing the jet for both air dominance and high-intensity tactical operations. According experts speculate that the inclusion of artificial intelligence, AI, elements, and enhanced data fusion capabilities is likely a priority in the development of this fighter. These advancements would enable better integration of information and seamless coordination with unmanned aerial systems, which is a hallmark of sixth-generation aircraft concepts. While detailed technical specifications remain under wraps, the mock-up represents China's ambition to keep pace in the race to develop sixth-generation air capabilities, potentially alongside developments in other countries, such as the United States' Next Generation Air Dominance, NGAD program, and Europe's Future Combat Air System, FCS. The United States first acknowledged China's sixth-generation fighter development about 2 years ago. China is advancing its response to the U.S. Air Force's Next Generation Air Dominance NGAD program, remarked General Mark D. Kelly, head of Air Combat Command ACC, in September 2022. General Kelly anticipates that China's highly classified efforts will yield a comparable system of systems approach to air combat, similar to what the U.S. Air Force envisions, including a sixth-generation manned fighter. We know Beijing keeps its cards close to the chest, but more importantly, we also know that it has struggled with the engines with its Chengdu J-20 Mighty Dragon. So it seems difficult to believe that the PLAAF has made a great leap forward from barely being able to deliver a fifth-generation fighter to suddenly producing a space plane that can somehow do it all, and then showing it to the world. However, skepticism surrounds China's ability to rapidly develop and deploy this technology. While it highlights China's aerospace aspirations, questions remain about its proper functionality, especially given Beijing's prior struggles with engine technology. The China International Aviation and Aerospace Exhibition kicked off on Tuesday outside the city of Zhuhai in the Guangdong province, marking the 75th anniversary of the founding of the People's Liberation Army Air Force, PLAAF. Since its beginning in 1996, the expo has highlighted the latest developments from China's aerospace industry. Also known as the Zhuhai Air Show or Air Show China, the biennial event is now the largest aviation trade expo in the People's Republic of China, and there has been speculation that the star of this year's show would be the Shenyang J-35A, the carrier-based variant of the Shenyang FC-31. Though the long-anticipated J-35A appeared from the skyline. The new stealth fighter jet's debut was brief, as it performed only a few maneuvers like fast ascending, rolling, and turning before vanishing into the sky, leaving the audience too eager to see more. However, another aircraft was especially noteworthy at this year's aerospace exhibition, the previously unrevealed White Emperor. The Bidi, or White Emperor, is a project from the state-owned aerospace and defense conglomerate AVIC to develop what state media has described as an integrated space air fighter, the Post reported, citing Voice of China, an arm of state broadcaster CCTV. The design concept includes the ability to fly at supersonic speeds and break through the Earth's atmosphere to operate in space. The report concluded, the emergence of the White Emperor B signals not just a technical achievement in stealth and fighter design, but a bold new chapter in China's aerospace ambitions, one that includes a clear aspiration to dominate not only the skies, but the space beyond. If you enjoy content like this, please go ahead and like and subscribe to this video because I appreciate all your support.